Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. It is a great privilege for me to have everyone here tonight. Very welcome to join this lecture recital and thanks for coming. The piece which I'm going to talk about is not only the first violin concerto of China, but also one of the most famous violin works in Chinese musical history. This concerto was originally and specially composed for violin instead of reduction work from some other Chinese instrument. It took advantage of Western musical medias and elements, such as taking violin as solo instrument, using of a full orchestra, instrumentation, sort of sonata form, and so on, to present a Chinese love story. The violin concerto entitled Butterfly Lovers was jointly composed by two composers, He Zhanhao and Gang Chen. We all know it is fairly unusual that one musical work was written by two composers simultaneously. To understand the reasons for this interesting case, let's get to know about the composers first. By the way, very fortunately, at the end of 2016, I had got a chance to meet one of the composers, Zhang Baohe, the first one. Then during the summer of 2017, I got another chance to make a visit to Gang Chen in his studio office. Okay, here it is. This picture was taken in his home, He Zhanhao's home. The order of the picture from the right side to the left is the lady is his wife. She's a very nice woman, and you know, she helped me a lot to set up this appointment. Without her help, I probably cannot meet him. So I want to thank for her. And the second one is the composer himself. He's a very talkative person. The young man is me, and the woman is my mom. Okay. He Zhanhao, Zhang Baohe, was born in a normal family of Zhejiang province. Zhejiang province is the one next to Shanghai, very close to each other. It's like from Texas to Louisiana in states. His father was a Chinese drama player, but he didn't want his son to continue his music career. Thus, he lent money for sending Zhang Baohe to study at school. However, Zhang Baohe never gave up his music dream. When he was 17 years old, he applied for a job of Zhejiang Cultural Troupe as his will. He was admitted by the troupe as a dancer, actor, and singer. Then, in 1952, he found himself a position in Zhejiang Yue Opera Troupe. Because of the job, he started to learn violin and got many opportunities to get to know the Yue Opera. So the experiences of working at Zhejiang Yue Opera Troupe lie a very solid foundation for his future creative career, especially bringing him the creation sources of Butterfly Lovers Violin Concerto. Later on, in 1955, for polishing and upgrading his violin skill and level, he applied for the Shanghai Conservatory of Music. When Zhang Baohe were talking about this experience, he usually would like to make fun of it. He said that when he was doing the audition, he was kind of pretty relaxed because he knew that his violin playing badly. And he never thought he would be accepted by the school. So compared with other applicants, he was more like a visitor instead of an applicant. Let me give you an example. Let's say there were 20 applicants for the audition, and everyone has an auditorial name. When one player finishes his playing, the judge will come out from the auditioning room and call the number for the next. Before Zhang Baohe, there were several players who played way better than that he did. But the funny thing is that they were so scared and so nervous, and they did not feel be ready even if when the judge called their numbers. For example, if we say Zhang Haohe is the number 10, then the judge came out from the room and called, "Next, number six, please." "Oh, he's using bathroom," Zhang Haohe said. "Okay, then number seven. Who's number seven?" "Likewise." "Sure. Number eight, then." "Excuse me, can I play?" "You're number eight?" "No, I'm actually number 10. "It's not your turn." "Okay. Number eight, where's number eight?" "I guess he's not here." Okay, you, come here." So that's how he went to the audition. So you can tell that he's pretty relaxed and ready for going to die anytime. Eventually, he was accepted by the school. The Butterfly Lover's Violin Concerto was started by his second school year of Shanghai Conservatory. Okay, now let's talk about another composer, Gang Chen. I met Mr. Gang Chen in his studio office. That's his studio office. He's a very famous Chinese composer who was born in a wealthy music family in Shanghai. His father was a famous Chinese popular songwriter during the 1930s. In early time, Gang Chen started to learn music under his father's guidance. He also studied with a Hungary pianist in composition and piano. When he became a student of Shanghai Conservatory of Music in 1955, he started with the dean of the conservatory and a residency music theorist from Russia. During that time, lots of Chinese school invited the musicians or scholars from Russia. Okay, I'm not gonna talk about the process of creation because I think we don't have the time for going for that. If you were interested in the historical background, and I did a research in my dissertation, so we can look at that. But here, I'd like to point one thing out, which is where the concerto came from. In 1950s, the Shanghai Real Opera Troupe created a drama called Liang Shanbo and Zhu Yingtai. That's the Chinese name for the Butterfly Lovers. Because of its tremendous success, many other opera troupes all over the country started to perform it on stage. Zhejiang Real Opera Troupe was one of them. As I mentioned before, that Zhang Haohe worked in this troupe for about 5 years. So he got lots of chance to know and play the drama. I here would like to show a video which is the original Yue Opera edition for the Butterfly Lovers. Please be aware of the actors and their singing styles, voice, and tone, because they give the two composers lots of inspirations.
This is the
Zhang Haohe was one of the members of the experimental group of nationalization for violin. The duty of this group is to explore the means of making Chinese national violin works. Before to create this violin concerto, Zhang Haohe actually wrote a Butterfly Lover's piece for string quartet as an experimental work. Actually, this piece for the string quartet should be regarded as the first draft or the first picture of the Butterfly Lover's Concerto. Very fortunately, I found this recording online. And the most, I'm going to show you the recording. And the most important thing, the first violin part in that recording was performed by Zhang Haohe himself. That would be cool, right? Okay, we can see how badly he... okay. Give you a sense of